During his visit to campus, Senator Corker also got a chance to look at some of the futuristic vehicles that have been developed by MTSU faculty and students.
This vehicle is our MTSU's version of a plug-in electric hybrid. Toyota, right over here, did one, but we did one also with our green energy fee project here at MTSU, the $8 energy fee. What it is, it started out a Blazer, but the only thing that's a Blazer now is the frame and the shell. So it's a solar electric hybrid. This vehicle is built to run off nothing but sun and water. Actually, the Ayatollah inspired me with this, because really, the thing that inspired it was when our hostages got taken in Iran, and I think that was 1978. And then what happened, I'm in agriculture, and fuel prices went to an outrageous $1.80 a gallon. Unbelievable.
I mean, I'm at $4 now, it is.
But before that happened, it was 50 cents for regular and 60 cents for high test.
This is the 2008 solar boat. This is the second hull that we've built. The first hull competed for 2 years. They did fairly well. This boat did a little bit better than the previous hull did. We're working on a new hull this year. We're going with a mono hull, deep V hull design. It has three solar panels. We only brought one today.
Unfortunately, it will take several years, perhaps decades, before we can break our dependence on petroleum-based transportation. And today's college students can't wait. They've had to come up with their own ways to get to class without breaking the bank.
I bike to school every morning. It's only about a 15-minute bike ride, if less. I use my bike every time, just around campus. Don't drive to school at all.
I walk about a mile to campus up Middle Tennessee, because gas prices just don't make it worth driving anymore.
Mostly what I do, I use my car as little as possible, because I don't want to pay that extra for gas. I try to think of ways that I can not use my car as much, because gas prices, they're awful, and not to mention you also got to take into account the mileage and stuff that you put on your car, so you have to pay for that as well. So it's best that you try to use some other form of transportation, or try like carpool and stuff like that.
I park over by the rec center and walk around school all day. The only traveling I really do is to work and to school. So work is 5 minutes from home and school is all the way out here. So.
Well, now I live in the apartments. And we have a little shuttle. Instead of driving to class, I take the shuttle to class, so I don't have to go keep putting gas in my car and driving and parking.
I started carpooling with my friend to come to class. So that kind of saves our gas. We just take turns carpooling now.
Things like going to the grocery store, maybe going to the gym. I try to do generally all in one trip, as opposed to make several different trips, things of that nature.